This is Europe in the 18th century. Smallpox is everywhere. 400,000 Europeans are dying from it each year. And there's no cure, but there might be some hope. There's a doctor who thinks he's found a way to fight the disease. All you need to do is let him infect you with some good, old-fashioned milkmaid pus. Of course, there's another doctor at the same time who says, well, sure, you could do that, but it might make your face look like a cow's. And the debate over vaccines began. Today, vaccinations are fairly common. Here's a quick recap of how they work. There are a number of different types of vaccines, but they're all meant to do the same thing. Give your body the ability to fight a disease without actually contracting it. Whether they use a dead or weakened virus or a toxin, the vaccine will make your body activate T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes, T cells and B cells. Those are simply defensive white blood cells that can remember how to battle those infections. And the idea of using a virus to prevent getting sick is older than you think. In 10th century China, people would inhale smallpox scabs in order to contract a mild form of the disease and therefore gain immunity. But it was messy and it didn't always work, and also, gross. Fast forward to 1796, British physician Edward Jenner discovered something slightly less gross, but way more effective. Milkmaids, for some unknown reason, were known for never contracting smallpox. Jenner believed that they were gaining immunity from cowpox, an unpleasant but not fatal disease. Jenner tested his theory by taking cowpox-infected pus and using it to inoculate an 8-year-old boy. This wasn't his son, by the way, which, yeah, does sound kind of messed up, especially when you realize he then later exposed the boy to smallpox in order to confirm his theory. Luckily, the test was a success, and Jenner began treating more people, his own son included. He called the process vaccination, using the Latin word vacca for cow. He published his work in 1798, which was met with some ridicule and repulsion. Big surprise, putting pus from a diseased person into your body didn't really fly with everyone. Another physician, William Rowley, made a particularly outrageous claim that the vaccine caused one boy to take on the features of a cow. And it didn't help that the vaccine wasn't perfect either. The smallpox vaccine has been plagued with negative side effects throughout its history. Even the modern day one had some potentially serious side effects. Plus, in the early 19th century, everything's taking place before germ theory and proper sterilization, so people would actually contract other diseases from contaminated vaccines. But despite its problems, the UK made vaccination mandatory in the mid-1800s. Britain actually became quite the fan of Jenner's work, with British Parliament eventually paying him what now amounts to around $1 million. This was the start of the eradication of one of humanity's most notorious diseases. In the 20th century, there were still 300 million deaths from smallpox worldwide. But this century, zero, nothing. The last recorded case was in 1978. Today, the disease exists only in protected labs. All thanks to a curious scientist, some milkmaid pus, and one really, really lucky kid. Getting vaccinated is pretty normal, but what about checking your poop? It's actually more important than you think. Let Amy tell you why in this video over here. So would you have taken the first vaccine ever? Let us know in the comments. Don't forget to like this video and be sure to subscribe for more Seeker every day of the week.